Thank you. Yeah, so I actually, I do believe that the 3D printing approach that I presented you two days ago to us is really a breakthrough. As I mentioned, oh, doesn't work.
Green.
Yes. Okay. Let's go back. So to focus the beam, an ultrasonic beam to the skull, and I guess this is actually very close to what Marilu presented before, because to modulate light with acousto-optic interaction, the way it's presented, change the wavelength of the light. First thing is to focus the ultrasound beam as precisely as possible within the brain, because actually you're not going to change the frequency of the light on one point, but over the size of the focal size where you can focus the beam. And it is not so easy to focus an ultrasound beam through the skull. The skull is going to distort the ultrasound beam and defocus the beam. So in the past 20 years, mostly, there's been a lot of development in order to refocus the beam through the skull, mostly based on CT data of the skull and how to reshape the beam by using thousands of elements and adjust the phase in order to restore a millimetric focus within the brain. And what we propose to do is achieve the same beam shaping, but with a much lower cost technology with just one single signal on one single element transducer, and to do so, produce a lens that we would cast. So this acoustic lens is made of a material which has a speed of sound different of that of water, so that any change in the thickness of the lens would result in a change in the travel time, so that we can restore the focus. And it actually works, showed you that without correction, the beam is scattered so that one could not be able to produce one single acoustic focus within the brain, but by using the lens, we can refocus the beam. And actually, there is, in this technology, if I go back, there is absolutely, there is no compromise, actually. And you see, we have individual transducers, but with the lens, there is a continuum. We change completely, continuously the phase. So this is actually equivalent to tens of thousands of transducers. So it's a very efficient way to focus the beam through the skull. It's not only cheap, but it's very efficient. We tested it on several skulls, so we could basically focus 10 times more power at the target point with this technique. And we believe that at least first step would be to use it for low intensity applications. And we are currently developing a prototype to achieve ultrasonic neural modulation with this lens-based technology. And we would not do the modulation within the MR, but by using a neural navigation, so outside the MR, and reposition the transducer on pre-acquisition MR images. Thank you.